Want to speak real Spanish from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at SpanishPod101.com.
Hello everyone, I'm Rosa, and today we'll be doing the 10 hardest words to pronounce in Spanish. So let's begin. Frigorífico, refrigerator, frigorífico, which means refrigerator. Cuando el frigorífico se estropeó, tuvimos que tirar mucha comida. When the refrigerator broke down, we had to throw away a lot of food. Correr, run. Me gustaría algún día correr una maratón. I would like to someday run a marathon. Espantapájaros, scarecrow. Me gusta cuando la gente viste a los espantapájaros como si fueran personas. I like when people dress up scarecrows as if they were people. Exquisito, delicious. Fuimos a un restaurante muy caro y toda la comida era exquisita. We went to a very fancy restaurant and all the food was very delicious. Idiosincrasia, idiosyncrasy. The next word is idiosincrasia, which means idiosyncrasy. Una de sus idiosincrasias es lavarse las manos cada hora. One of his idiosyncrasies is washing his hands every hour. Perro, dog. Cuando era pequeña tenía miedo de los perros. When I was a child, I was scared of dogs. Niño, child. Cuando era niño, se portaba muy mal con los otros niños. When he was a child, he was very bad to the other children. Paraguas, umbrella. The next word is paraguas, which means umbrella. Siempre me olvido el paraguas en los sitios. I always forget my umbrella at places. Pelo, hair. The next word is pelo, which means hair. Me corté el pelo hace poco. I cut my hair recently. Pingüino, penguin. The next word is pingüino, which means penguin. Me gusta la forma de andar de los pingüinos. I like how penguins walk. So this is the end of today's 10 hardest words to pronounce in Spanish. I hope you learned something, and thank you very much for watching this video. Please don't forget to subscribe. Bye! Pingüino again. Pingüinos. Hi everyone, I'm Rosa, and today we'll be doing 10 phrases to amaze native speakers. So let's begin. El español es divertido y fácil de aprender. Spanish is fun and easy to learn. El español es divertido y fácil de aprender. Spanish is fun and easy to learn. I think the pronunciation is very easy in Spanish. Yeah.
Aparte de saber español, también puedo hablar algunos otros idiomas. Apart from knowing Spanish, I can speak a few other languages as well.
Aparte de saber español, también puedo hablar algunos otros idiomas. Apart from knowing Spanish, I can speak a few other languages as well. Tell me which other languages you can speak. I can speak English. A bit of Japanese and French, but yeah, I have to study more.
Estoy aprendiendo español por mí mismo. I'm learning Spanish all by myself.
Estoy aprendiendo español por mí mismo. I'm learning Spanish all by myself. So good for you. Like, I know it's hard, but if you are constant and you do something every day, I think you can also like learn languages by yourself. Like today there are so many resources on the internet.
Hablaré español como un nativo en 3 años.
I'll speak Spanish like a native speaker in 3 years.
Hablaré español como un nativo en 3 años.
I'll speak Spanish like a native speaker in 3 years. Good luck!
He estado aprendiendo español por 10 años.
I've been learning Spanish for 10 years. He estado aprendiendo español por 10 años. I've been learning Spanish for 10 years. Yeah, I might have been studying English for longer than that.
Me tomó solo un año para hablar fluidamente.
It took me only 1 year to become fluent.
Me tomó solo un año para hablar fluidamente.
It took me only 1 year to become fluent. Wow. I admire you so much.
Gracias, pero en realidad no soy un hablante nativo.
Thank you, but I'm not a native speaker, actually. Gracias, pero en realidad no soy un hablante nativo. Thank you, but I'm not a native speaker, actually. Tell me your secrets.
Puedo memorizar alrededor de 50 palabras nuevas en español al día.
I can memorize around 50 new Spanish words a day.
Puedo memorizar alrededor de 50 palabras nuevas en español al día.
I can memorize around 50 new Spanish words a day.
Wow. It's important to be constant. Yeah. Just be sure to revise like the words you have studied before so you don't forget.
Puedo ver películas en español sin subtítulos.
I can watch Spanish movies without subtitles.
Puedo ver películas en español sin subtítulos.
I can watch Spanish movies without subtitles. I still use subtitles for English. Sé cómo conjugar todos los verbos irregulares.
I know how to conjugate all the irregular verbs.
Sé cómo conjugar todos los verbos irregulares.
I know how to conjugate all the irregular verbs.
Yeah, there are a lot of them, so that would be great if you knew how to did all of them right. There might even be Spanish people who cannot do that properly in some cases. So this is the end of today's 10 phrases to amaze native speakers. So I hope you get the chance to use them. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Bye.
Yeah, I can. Teach me.
Want to learn Spanish anywhere, anytime? Get the Innovative Language 101 app for free.
Hi everybody, Rosa here. Welcome to Ask a Teacher, where I'll answer some of your most common Spanish questions. The question for this lesson is, what are some popular Spanish idioms? In English, we have our fair share of idioms like, it's raining cats and dogs, or even, what's up? Here are some Spanish idioms you should know. Number 10 is estar empanado, meaning to be spaced out. Literally, it means to be breaded. In Spain, we have a lot of breaded foods like la empanada gallega. So every time your mind freezes and you can think, you are getting empanado or empanada. Number 9 is dormir como un tronco, meaning to sleep like a trunk. This means that you slept very well. For example, he dormido como un tronco, meaning I slept like a trunk. Number 8, chorizo, means sausage. And if you are carnivorous, you are going to find Spanish chorizo delicious. But don't be surprised if you hear this word in reference to a person. That means they are a thief, burglar, or swindler. Number 7 is one that doesn't make much sense, but you'll often hear. It is hace un tiempo de perros. Literally, it's a dog weather, meaning it's terrible weather. Number 6 is a phonetic challenge. Qué chorrada. Chorrada, wow, sounds difficult. We have the CH and a double R. So what does chorrada mean? If we say qué chorrada, we are expressing that something is not important, has no sense, or is absurd. Number 5 is costar un ojo de la cara, which means it's ridiculously expensive, but it literally means it costs an eye out of the head. Number 4, aprobar por los pelos, literally means to pass by the hair, referring to an exam. If you say aprobé por los pelos, you're saying that you got the lowest score or close to it, but passed the exam. Hopefully, you don't use this expression too much. Number 3 is qué guay, meaning cool. Here, we have a very useful multipurpose word. Do you want to go to the beach? Guay. Do you like my trousers? Qué guays. How was the party last night? Muy guay. It's similar to good, okay, perfect, or beautiful. However, be careful. It should only be used in casual or colloquial situations. Number 2 is tener un cacao. Literally translated, it means to have a cacao. However, the real meaning is to have a lot of trouble or to be in a mess. Lastly, number 1 is tener el guapo subido, which literally means to have the good looking up. The meaning of this may be easy for you to guess. You can use this phrase when suddenly one of your friends looks stunning. ¿Te ha pasado algo bueno? Hoy tienes el guapo subido. Did anything good happen to you? Today you're looking handsome. How was this lesson? Pretty interesting, right? Do you have any more questions? Please leave them in the comments below and I'll try to answer them. ¡Hasta luego! ¡See you later!
Hi everybody, Rosa here. Welcome to Ask a Teacher, where I'll answer some of your most common Spanish questions. The question for this lesson is, what are false friends? There are a lot of words that look similar in English and Spanish, but they don't always mean the same thing. False friends are a great name for them because they can be a bit deceptive. Here are some of the most common false friends. Beware of these so you can avoid misunderstanding when speaking Spanish with others. Asistir doesn't mean to help, that is, ayudar. Asistir is to attend. For example, to attend a concert could be asistir a un concierto. Likewise, un asistente is an attendee, and asistencia is attendance. In a more shocking example, molestar isn't as bad as it sounds, it just means to bother. And you won't find un éxito in a building, éxito means success. For your studies, lectura is another one that is easy to misinterpret. Lectura means reading. And a lecture could be una conferencia or una clase. Another example is una carpeta, which isn't a carpet, but a folder. And una librería is actually a bookstore, so don't expect to borrow anything for free. The word for library is biblioteca. And what's how you use actual? Because actual means current. Actualmente means currently. Be careful with embarazada too. Embarrassed is avergonzado for men and avergonzada for women. Don't use embarazado with a man because it means pregnant. If you see sopa on a restaurant menu, don't be alarmed. It's just soup. If you hear someone say delito though, which may be mistaken for delight, you should be concerned because it's actually crime. Last but not least, constipado can be a bit confusing. As an adjective, it means constipated, but used as a noun, it refers to the common cold. Pretty interesting, right? I hope that answers the questions. If you have any other questions, please leave a comment below and I'll try to answer them. Hasta la próxima!